So one question that we get from commenters online is, can RetroFoam be used to insulate a floor? Well, let's talk about it. Well, first, what we should discuss is what floor in the house we're actually talking about. So if you're thinking about the floor as in the first floor of your house, and underneath that floor is either a slab or a crawl space, can or should you use RetroFoam to insulate that floor? No, not really. Now, the reason I say that is because typically, 99% of the time, I know there might be one weird house out there that's not the case, but typically, underneath that floor, either if you go look underneath the floor on the slab or inside the crawl space, that floor is going to be completely open. The floor joists underneath are going to be open to the ground or that slab underneath. So there's not an enclosed cavity, meaning if you try to inject RetroFoam in there, it's just gonna fall either onto the slab or into your crawl space. So again, if we're talking about your first floor of your house, insulating that floor itself using RetroFoam, 9 times out of 10, it can't be done because it's not enclosed. If you are the 1 out of 100 where it is enclosed, it's possible, but the process can be a little complicated. You do have to drill into the floor, obviously. There's going to be many gaps and openings that can cause foam to get all over the place. So in theory, is it possible if it's enclosed? Yes, but there will be a lot of complications. Now, the next type of floor I want to talk about is the floor between the first and second story of your home. So again, we're talking about the ceiling of your first story and the floor of your second story. Can this area be insulated with RetroFoam? Possibly, it can be, but there are some things to keep in mind. First thing is, what is the thickness of that floor? And something to keep in mind with injection foam is, if you put injection foam on too thick, it could have issues curing. It could potentially collapse on itself because of the weight. Now, again, these are kind of extreme cases, but if you have a 12-inch space, well, you could potentially run into issues like this. Just things to be aware that it is a little more complicated. But let's say that you have the Goldilocks situation. All the stars aligned, and let's say you have a 6 or a 4-inch cavity between your first and second floor. And let's also assume that all of the gaps and crevices, nooks and crannies are sealed up. Because like I said with the first situation, a major risk when you're trying to do a floor or a ceiling with injection foam is that it will find every little opening to get out, and you will have foam squeezing itself out of little cracks and crevices on ceilings, walls, vents, all kinds of things. And that's the point of foam. It will find its way into those openings. That's what it's designed for. Assuming all of those stars align, can this be done? Yes, it is possible. So if you think a floor in your house could fall into one of these categories and it might work for you, go to our link below to our Find a Dealer page. Talk to your local RetroFoam dealer about the specifics of your floor and learn how they can help you make your home more comfortable today. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.